back in the New York groove. I'm back. Ah! Cheers. Yep. Yep. Hey. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, everybody. I want to give a big thank you to Chris over at The Rewired Soul. Last week or so, he stumbled across one of my videos. He followed me. He said, you know what, man, you're doing good stuff, keep it up. DM'd me on Twitter. We had a little chat, all that jazz. And I was like, you know what, I'm feeling good. Then he had a live stream. He played one of my videos in it, which I was just blown away by. And he even went as far as to give me a proper shout out in one of his videos, which just blew my mind completely, and the support I've received ever since then has been fantastic. So I want to give him a big thanks yet again, and I want to give a big welcome to everybody who is new to my YouTube channel. Hopefully I do enough to keep you here. Hopefully you don't regret subscribing to me. Hopefully I can create some content that'll make you laugh, you'll enjoy it, maybe make you feel a little bit sick. As long as I invoke a response, that's fine. I'm not as good as the Rewired Soul, but I'd like to think that I can try to be at least maybe half as good. Now, we live in the day and age in YouTube where everybody's just obsessed with documentary. So this is a very exciting time for me. Now, since the Shane Dawson series and Jake Paul dropped, everybody has just been going crazy, losing their mind, and Jake Paul himself has jumped aboard that bandwagon, and he has started his own series called Jake Paul Uncut. Now, the purpose of this series is to just peel back the covers, if you will, and show Jake Paul in his most natural, unedited state. Now, he claims that this reality TV show is real. It's actual real life. And unlike other reality TV shows, like my personal favorite Game of Thrones, this series is 100% real, unfiltered, raw. What you see is what you get. Now, he says this series is gonna show every possible aspect of his life, from business, personal, except for illegal stuff like him on the toilet, him doing cocaine. All that stuff is gonna be left off camera, which straight away is just making me feel like I'm missing out on something. But he says he's gonna make every attempt to show every possible thing in his life that he can. Now, we've had one episode already, and at the beginning of this episode, he pretty much said, you know what? I'm kind of sick of doing kids content. I want to break out. I want to do something a little bit more real, a little bit more me, a little bit more adult-oriented content. Now, immediately I think about Miley Cyrus and all the Disney Channel kids and all the Nickelodeon kids. These are the people that grew up on TV. They didn't really have a chance to grow naturally. They grew up in front of a camera and they've been doing the same thing for years and years and years. And eventually everybody reaches that point where they want to just branch off and do something a little bit edgy, steer away from the kids' content, and start doing something a little bit more adult. That hasn't always worked out for people, but everybody, it seems, goes through that phase. And of course, Jake Paul alludes to the fact that Shane Dawson just influenced him exponentially in this series, and can he live up to the lofty expectations set by Shane Dawson? Because if you're gonna do a YouTube documentary series, you've gotta do it right, and Shane Dawson does it right, and anybody who doesn't do it right is instantly gonna draw criticism. So straight away, before the ball's even rolling, he has got a mountain to climb. Can he climb it? I don't know. Is this series gonna be good? I'm not sure. What's the point of this series overall? I'm not 100% sure. Now, episode one is titled, Here's Why Erica and I Broke Up. So straight away you say, ooh, this is interesting. I can't wait to click on it. I wanna see what it's about. I wanna see some tea spilt. I wanna hear all the juicy gossip. So let's click on the video and find out. So to summarize the whole video, the video went for about half an hour, and a lot of it didn't actually touch on the breakup. Okay, I know what you're thinking. Hang on, the title said, here's why Erica and I broke up, and you're not talking about the breakup? What's going on there? Oldest YouTube trick in the book, my friend. Clickbait. This video was a bit of clickbait. Now, when they talked about the breakup, I say they, I mean Jake. It was pretty much Jake sitting in front of a camera, Big Brother confessional style, and he was saying, oh, Eric and I broke up, we were so toxic for each other, oh, it just wasn't working, we acknowledged that we weren't good for each other, we were just really toxic. I swear he used the word toxic like 20 times, like he's been playing Pokemon Let's Go and his favorite move is toxic. That was it. That was the extent we went to when we're talking about the breakup. Just him talking about the breakup, talking about being toxic. And there was a whole bunch of other Team 10 stuff going on. I think Jake Paul's actually trying to reboot Team 10. Well, that's what they spoke about. In the video, he was filming a video where he had like Team 10 lookalikes come into the house and he like threatened him with a knife. It was really weird. And then at one point in the video, Erica Costa actually arrives at the house. Now, they kill the cameras for obvious reasons because, you know, she doesn't want this stuff filmed. But that just happened to be the most interesting part of the video, is when Erica actually showed up and they actually talked about breaking up. And I'm pretty sure they actually broke up, but we didn't see any of this on camera. So that would have been the most interesting thing to hit the internet, I think, at this time, would be video footage of the actual breakup, but for obvious reasons, we didn't see it. So they spoke about the breakup a whole bunch of times. The breakup actually happened in the video, kind of, but we didn't see it. So overall, the video didn't really give us much. At the end of it, I was just like, oh, is that it? Like, okay.
Anything else? That was it.
Now, the series trailer, it shows a couple of little interesting topics. So the series itself does have potential. I think we can see some more interesting things as we go along. But as far as episode one goes, it was kind of a stinker. They're eventually going to touch on the fact that Jake cheated on Erica, which that's exciting. That I can't wait for. But as far as episode one goes, it's in the book now. It's kind of a waste of time. It's kind of boring. If you want to go watch it, by all means, go watch it, but I didn't really get that much from it. It doesn't leave me with a whole lot of hope for the series, but as I said, the series trailer does look kind of juicy, kind of interesting. We see Jake Paul and Logan Paul conversation citing, which will be interesting to see. But then again, there's every possibility that we've already seen the most interesting part of the series, and that was the breakup. But then again, I'm optimistic. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. But overall, I'm not 100% sure what the point of the series is. I know he wants to show himself in a more relaxed, more uncut setting. Hey, there you go. Word association. But I'm not sure what is to gain from it. I mean, we saw Jake Paul in a pretty vulnerable, natural state in the Shane Dawson series, and that series did him a whole lot more good than it did bad. So now he wants to go and do his own series where he shows himself in his natural setting, and I'm not sure what is to gain from it. You would want him to be more sympathetic to the public, but from what I've seen from the trailer, it just makes him out to be a massive twat. Spoiler alert. So yeah, I don't know. As I said, I'm optimistic. I'm gonna give the series a chance. I'm gonna watch it from start to finish. But episode one, we've started off on not the best footing. It was kind of boring. The most interesting topic wasn't really covered that much. So instantly you're like, you feel a bit cheated because it's like, oh, you promised us the breakup and you didn't really give us the breakup. Like, come on, bro. I want a refund. And yeah, that's it. That's it. It's been a while since I've made a video and I'm very excited to be back on the YouTube grind, if you will. I've got my coffee grind. I'm gonna go grind on my couch a bit later. It feels good to be back. For all you guys that are new to the channel, I hope you did enjoy. Please don't unsub. If you subbed thinking you were gonna get some good stuff and then you see me and then you unsub, I understand, but please don't do it. That would break my heart. Once again, big shout out and thank you to Chris over at The Rewired Soul. Without you, my friend, this would not be possible. I was struggling to get over 200 subs and I didn't think I'd be able to do it. But with your help, my man, I did it. And now we're on the road to 300 and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling excited. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time I've got. So until next time, I'll see you later. Bye.